Hey, this is Baylor again, and in this tutorial I'll be teaching you how to make a navigation with PHP. So as you can see here, I have three links, and it's Home, Tutorials, and Scooby-Dooby-Doo. So what I'm going to do is, instead of having to call out each one of these links, like href equals home, and this one's, oh, we're on the tutorials page, so I'll do href equals tutorials, and class equals selected or whatever. You're just going to be able to do it with PHP, and it's a lot quicker. So to make this navigation, all I did was put in my a function called navbar, and in single quotes, I specified what link I'm wanting to call. So I'm going to teach you how to do that. What I've done is I've created a PHP file called function.php. You can create that, and this is what we'll start doing. I'm going to do start my PHP out, and I'm going to make a function. I'm going to call this navbar. And we'll be calling a variable through this, or passing data through this function. So I'm going to give that data, put that data into the variable called page. Now what I like to do when I do this is put in a comment section all the links I'll be using. That way I know which ones to call, and I'll show you why in a minute. So I'm going to make one URL is going to be home, and tutorials, and last one, Scooby-Dooby-Doo. And I'm not going to fix that. Okay, so now if you've never used arrays before, this is going to be kind of difficult. But if you used arrays, you'll understand why this is the better way to do this. And if you haven't used arrays, you'll see why you need to start using arrays, because arrays are awesome. So I'm going to make a variable called links, and this is going to hold these three links right here that I specified above. So I'm going to do links is equal to array, and I just have this out like this, so it's easier for me to read it. And my link 1 is going to be home, and I'll explain what this does in a minute. Just kind of type it out as you see what I do. And it's equal to href equals number. And home. Comma. And on the next line, do tutorials. And it's going to be equal to if I could just type a little bit faster, finishing that link, quote, comma, just like I did on home, and Scooby. And it's equal to I'm just going to put Scooby here, just to save time. Just finish off that quote and you're done. Okay, so what have we done here? We've created a link called variables, a variable called links. We've given an array, and in this array we've called three main items. And if you haven't used arrays, basically what you can to call these three items, you would use the following code. Links, and then in a square bracket, and inside your double quotes, and for instance, if I wanted to call Scooby, I would simply type in Scooby, and this is going to call this data, and this data is equal to href equals number sign and Scooby. Okay, so if I wanted to echo this out on the page, I could just put this right here, and it would echo out href equals Scooby. Simple as that. It's pretty simple. And you can make this as complicated as you want. You can add as many links as you want. So now I'm going to go ahead and move on to the next part of this tutorial. So the next thing we want to do is we want to see which link we're calling out onto the page. So to do that, I'm going to use a switch function. And we're going to be passing page. And if you haven't used switch functions before, you can go to php.net /switch, like this. Wow. Like that, and you'll learn all about the switch function. Or if you're in PHP Designer 2008, just click on it and press F1, and it opens up the PHP manual here. Well, function's not found. Anyways, so let's get started with this. Basically, I'm just going to find out which one of these three have been called, and to do that, I'm going to do case, home, and add a colon, and now I'm going to do if they did. What this is going to do is it's going to take whatever information's in the page variable, it's going to put it here, and then basically we're doing case, and if page is equal to home, then we're going to do the following. And it's basically if or else statements. You're going to do case home, do this. Case tutorials, do this. Case Scooby, do this. So if the case was home, then I'm going to go ahead and do links home, and I'm going to make that equal to span home. And I'm going to pause the video because I'm running out of time here. But basically, I'm going to redo this right here throughout the for tutorials and Scooby. Okay, so I've just gone ahead and done the next few. And now we're done with this part. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to come below the switch. Make sure you are not inside the switch curly brackets. And add output is equal to links home, and this is where you can change the order to whatever you want, and I'm just going to leave it the way it is, and I'm going to add a space and links tutorials, and one more, links Scooby. Just like that, and come down on the next line and put return output, just like that, and I am at 727, so I should be able to finish this. Okay, so we have navbar here, and if I replace this with just home, make sure you go ahead and add this variable or whatever link you want. So as you can see, we have home, tutorials, and Scooby. If I come down here and I change this to Scooby real quick and reload this page, I'll reload the page like this. As you can see, now Scooby is turned into the span item and the rest are the other normal links. So you can do this in a bunch of ways with if you have a big navigation and you're crawling on the same page a lot. So I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and thanks for watching.